that the mega wealthy, they actually pay a lower rate of taxes than many of the people who are working for them. And this is something that President Obama has picked up on, saying it's a basic issue of fairness.
Call it the Warren Buffett rule. Warren Buffett saying his secretary shouldn't pay more in taxes than he does. But is it true? Do millionaires and billionaires in this country pay a lower tax rate than middle-class families? Well, it depends. Let's say you have Sue. She makes a nice salary of $1 million, putting her in the 35% tax bracket. Jill makes $50,000 a year, or the 25% tax bracket. Between those two, Sue is making more and paying more in taxes. But now let's add in Rita. She's done very well for herself and doesn't actually have a regular job. She lives off her investments and makes $1 million. She actually pays a lower tax rate than both Sue and Jill of 15% on dividends and capital gains. That's what President Obama wants to change.
It is wrong that in the United States of America, a teacher or a nurse or a construction worker who earns $50,000 should pay higher tax rates than somebody pulling in $50 million.
The reality is about 46% of American households paid no federal income tax in 2011, in part because of home mortgage deductions, the child tax credit, education credits, and credits for the working poor. The true burden of who pays the highest share of taxes in the United States is really the upper middle class and moderately wealthy families. According to IRS data, people making between $100,000 and $200,000 a year pay 25% of the share of income taxes. People making between $200,000 and $500,000 a year pay about 20% of the total. That's almost half of the taxes combined. But that's not to say the rich get off scot-free.
There are roughly 235,000 millionaires in America, and they paid $177 billion in income taxes in 2009. That's an average tax payment of over $750,000 each.
How much money would the president's tax proposal on millionaires raise for the government, and what would it look like? The Obama administration is leaving those questions for Congress.
We're not going to give the Congress a detailed proposal for how to meet that specific principle now, because there's lots of different ways to do that. But we think it should be the basic foundation of tax reform, and we're going to fight to make sure that's part of what Congress considers and ultimately delivers.
Conservatives and Republicans argue the reason the capital gains tax rate is 15% is because it's supposed to encourage investment and savings, and the last thing you want to do is to create a disincentive. The other argument that you're going to be hearing from Republicans is that, yes, there is a 15% rate on capital gains, but for wealthy individuals who have their own corporation, essentially your Warren Buffetts of the world, well, their company's income has already been taxed at a 35% rate, and then on top of that, there's the 15% capital gains. You know, of course, Wolf, Democrats have a very different perspective on this, and that is where the fault line is. Wolf?
They certainly do. This debate is only just beginning. We've heard a lot, but we're going to hear a lot more.